of the King James, for whatsoever is born of God is victorious over the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, even our faith. Who is it that is victorious over, that conquers the world, but he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God, who adheres to, trusts in, and relies on that fact? Amen. I would like to change one word in that verse, and that is the last word, from fact to truth. Amen. Glory to God. I think it's all right, amen, because the man that interpreted was human, amen, and I believe that God will rather that we trust in truth than facts, because facts can change. Look at somebody and say, but truth never changes. Amen. We're going to begin this message, amen, from this theme: faith is the victory.
Amen.
Amen. Look at somebody and say, faith
is
the victory. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Faith is the victory. In the Gospel of Luke, the 17th chapter and verse 5, amen, the apostles said unto the Lord, increase our faith. Amen. The apostles, amen, they said unto the Lord Jesus, amen, increase our faith. And Jesus began to teach them a lesson, amen, using their faith, amen, as a seed called mustard, or a mustard seed known to be the smallest of herbs, amen, that man plants in the ground. Amen. And he said, if you have faith that of a size of a mustard seed, you can say, somebody said say, you can say to that mountain, be thou removed, and the mountain got to move. Now watch what he said. He said, if you have faith of that, of a seed, amen, which is a mustard seed, you can say, amen, to that mountain, be thou removed, and the mountain has to be removed. See, faith is the victory. Amen. But faith has to be attached to words. Mm-hmm. I said faith has to be attached to words. Jesus said to them, if you say to the mountain, be thou removed, then the mountain must be removed, because you had faith in what you said. Amen. Somebody look at somebody and say, if you have faith and what you say, you can have the victory. Let me help somebody with that. Amen. Romans 10, 17, amen, answers, amen, that. And it says, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Lord, why do I need to hear the word? Amen. First, in order for me to speak the word, I got to hear the word. In my hearing the word, amen, I transfer it from my ear gate to my mouth gate. In other words, now I'm saying what I'm hearing. Amen. And what I'm hearing is the word of God, by which I have faith in. So if I say what God says, he will honor what I says. And whatever victory that I am declaring, I already have it, because I'm saying what I heard God say. Are you with me on this? Amen. Glory to God. Faith is, amen, and we know, the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Faith is, amen, faith is the substance, the stuff, if you will, amen, the element, if you will, amen, and whatever it is that you're hoping for, faith becomes the title deed of that which you are hoping for, because what I say in faith, amen, gives me the victory, amen, in that and over that, concerning what I desire. So I now have the title deed to what I say, because what I say, I believe is mine. Amen? Amen. Amen. Look at somebody and say, if you say it and believe it, you shall receive it. Amen. So you got to understand, and I got to understand more, amen, that if I'm going to have a victory, it has to be in the realm of faith. So faith is the victory. If I have the faith, I automatically have the victory. Amen. When we look, amen, at faith and what faith does, amen, faith assures success. Amen. Look at somebody. Say faith. Positively assures success. In 2 Chronicles 2 and 20, and they rose up early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God, so shall you be established. Believe in his prophets, so shall ye prosper. Amen. King Jehoshaphat said, if you believe in the Lord your God, you shall be established. If you believe also in his prophets, so shall ye prosper. Amen. Everything that we will be established in and prosper in has to be founded upon God. And if God said it, God will do it. Huh? If God promised it, God will bring it to pass. All I got to be reminded of is to keep saying, 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 saying what God said. I got to excuse myself from other conversations that come into my ear gate, things that whisper to me and tell me I can't. And I got to remember what God said. He said, I can do all things through him who strengthened me. Anybody strengthened by God today? Oh, hallelujah. Amen. So the king was letting them know, amen, Judah, here's what will take place, amen, if you would just believe in the Lord your God. If you would allow your faith, amen, to tell you that God is who he said he is. Amen. I can't see God just like you. Amen. I can't tangibly feel God just like you. Amen. I don't know where he is, amen, right now, but I believe he's where he said he is. Amen. He's present with us always, even to the end of the world. And if God is in the midst of us, amen, he's ready to bless us. And that right early. Somebody tell God, thank you. Amen. Faith is a fundamental duty. Glory to God. In John 6, amen, verses 28 and 29, then said they unto him, what shall we do that we might work the works of God? Verse 29, Jesus answered and said unto them, this is the work of God, that ye believe on him whom he hath sent. In other words, Jesus was the physical word. Amen. Jesus was the word incarnate. And Jesus said, believe on me for my very work's sake. Hallelujah. Amen. So they had a working word in front of them that was wrapped in flesh. We got a working word in front of us that's wrapped with leather. We got a working word, amen, that's working in front of us, that's being spoken out of the mouth of the prophet, the apostle, the pastor, the evangelist, the teacher. Great. Three of y'all believe that. Great. Praise the Lord. Great. You're going to get it. Amen. Great. So shall you prosper.
That's right. Yeah. We've spoken.
Amen. So, amen, the fundamental duty of the believer, amen, is to believe on him who spoke. I remember years ago, Deacon Armwood, he had a sign. I think it was on the front of his car, his truck, and it read, amen, God said it, I believe it, and that settles it. All right. And that stayed in my spirit, glory to God, from that day to this day. God said it, I believe it, that settles it. In other words, I don't have to conference between what he said and what I say I believe and knowing it's settled. Amen. In other words, amen, in between God said, I believe, and that settled, I'm just sea lying. Look at somebody, so you got to learn how to sea lie. In other words, in your moment of Selah, you were just standing still, amen, waiting to see the salvation of the Lord in whom you believe. Am I right, somebody? In other words, amen, the doctor said, I had this and that and the other. The doctor have declared that what I have could be terminal. The doctor said, amen, that what you got is rare and unusual, but God said, by his stripes, we are healed. I choose to be healed over being sick. Come on, somebody. If I got to choose one of them, I'm choosing healing. And thank be to God, the one that said I'm healed, I can trust him with my healing. For he said, I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee of all thine diseases. He said, I sent my word, and my word healed them. Huh? So all I got to do is just have faith in what his word says. Because when I get faith, I got the victory. See, faith and fear cannot be operating in you at the same time, although both of them start with an F. Amen. You got to counsel fear out for faith to take resident up in you. Because faith is not going to stay in you and you letting doubt room. You letting fear room. Amen. You renting a room to anxiety.
Uh-oh, watch out.
Faith ain't going to stay up in there because faith know that it can't do anything as long as those three tenants are in your life. But when you make up your mind that I'm ready to evict doubt, I'm ready to evict anxiety, I'm ready to evict fear, then faith is ready to settle in you in every way that you need victory. God will give it to you because now you have a faith that overcometh the world.
That's right. Amen.
My faith overcomes the world. Amen. So faith, amen, becomes, amen, not only, amen, my allegiance, amen, to God, amen, because I believe in him, but faith gives me to know that I have the victory in every way. So I look at faith as being my weapon. Look at somebody, say, faith is a weapon. Faith is a defensive weapon. Ephesians 6 and 16, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. In other words, the Lord is saying through Paul, as he speaks to the Ephesian church, amen, you have a defense. Oh, hallelujah. In other words, the Lord has given us an offense and a defense. Our offense is the sword.
There you go. That's it.
I said our offense is the sword. The sword that's sharper, come on now, amen, than any razor you know. The sword, amen, that cuts on both sides. Talk about the word of God, sharper than any two-edged sword. Come on, somebody. Glory to God. Amen. So I have an offensive weapon, which is my sword, which is the word of God. Amen. Now, out of my sword, I have established a relationship with God that gives me a defensive weapon, which is a shield. I fight with the word. Come on, somebody. And I lift up the shield of faith.
Yes, sir.
So when the enemy fire his darts at me,
yes,
and fire his arrows at me, and when the terrors come by night,
defense.
I'm able to defend myself. Look at somebody say, I'm able to defend myself. Amen. Because you got to understand that there is no weapon formed against you as a believer that shall prosper. Because number one, after receiving Jesus Christ, you become God's property, and the Bible calls you the heritage of God. Look at somebody and say, I'm God.